afternoon and welcome back. Just one clarification, after you left, we analyzed the tablets which you had returned because I was curious as to why only 25 responses were collected. Apparently what we found out is that some tablets were connected to workshop Wi-Fi point and not to Akash. So unfortunately there are multiple Wi-Fi access points in this lab. It told us that the manual will have to be written more carefully when we write for the students to use and so on. Because what Mr. Rajesh Kushalkar assured me is actually yesterday evening they had put some 30 of their staff and interns and others, each one was given two tablets, and they had tested that all 60 responses were getting collected. So there's nothing wrong with the technology. I was concerned, you know, that if you have only 50% hit rate. Anyway, so thank you very much for volunteering to participate in that project as well. We'll run it simultaneously. As I told you, I've started writing down the details of the partnership that we will try to enter into. You will all get a mail containing a link to a form which you'll have to fill up. And the form will have to be printed and will have to be signed by the head of your institution, which will effectively say that they would be willing to undertake these kind of experiments jointly. They will be willing to work on the projects, etc. We are still not decided. I have already told you that we will provide in that agreement for approximately 110 number of Akash devices. I'll say approximately because there may be some more or less depending upon the class thing that you have. The second thing, as I said, you would require a server and Wi-Fi points. Now, ordinarily, we would expect the institutions to provide a small server and access points as well. But we had thought of providing some funding support for that activity as well. We'll not be procuring these things and sending because each college is best placed to procure a server and keep it. That server will have to be a Ubuntu server or a Linux server. We'll of course provide all the software because that is all open source software along with the applications and along with the content management software, etc. In fact, if you wish, you can also use that server for future workshops as a local Moodle server or something. But in any case, that server will have to have a local Moodle which should be accessed by at least the students who participate in the Akash related project classroom. But even once you set it up, you know, you can popularize it amongst other teachers and everybody can use it. Some of you might already be using it. To this server, you'll have to connect the Wi-Fi access points. We have estimated the pricing for the Wi-Fi access points. Decent Wi-Fi access points are available for somewhere between 2,000, 2,500 rupees to 3,000 rupees kind of range. We will provide financial support for up to five Wi-Fi access points. So at least one classroom, one lab, say if you are hostels, then a hostel, et cetera, could be covered. And we'll also provide up to, as I said, up to 75,000 rupees for the server and the associated maintenance. So what you may do is, the server does not typically cost more than 50, 55,000 rupees. You can use the other money to depute a person for say 6 months or something, and you can pay him some technical officer who can, you can pay him some honorarium to take care of that particular. So that is roughly the plan. This workshop itself will start from 25th. I hope you have already given to our team the number of participants that you can accommodate maximally in your institute, considering the totality of the situation at your place. Not just the classroom, but availability of one or more labs where people can access computers. You are already aware of the back-end software that is required, which is the Scilab that you will have to install. That is the only important thing that we require here. And of course, internet access for people to access the Moodle. These are the two things which are required. Okay, so with this, we come to the conclusion. The registration, by the way, the online registration of provisional and formally enrolled participants has crossed 8,500. Now, that's a fairly large number. The test will be up to us now. Whether we will, in the next 10 days, we will try to prepare a very good schedule, and the details will work it out with Professor Karmalkar, who is in Chennai, has been calling constantly, Professor Sahana Murthy and Professor Santosh Naruna. And as I said, we'll of course arrange for some additional lectures and so on. The lab work and the afternoon discussion session is very critical. And as I said, it will all be up to you and your colleagues who might be willing to help you or who will participate in this work. I just wanted to get a judgment on what are the large numbers or which are the centers which could accommodate very large number of participants, much larger than 50 or something. There are some people who said they could accommodate about 100. So I hope that you might have an auditorium of a capacity of 150, but these 100 people in multiple labs can simultaneously access computers and internet. That is what is important. So with this, we come to the closure of this workshop. First of all, my heartfelt thanks for sparing your time during vacation period and coming here. I hope you agree that this is a very exciting attempt that we are making. A mega workshop of this kind has never been attempted in the world. And I believe that it's high time India started doing good things for the first time ahead of rest of the countries. So this is one opportunity. The format for this particular brief closing ceremony is that I would request some of you to make your observations, not only on this workshop, but the subsequent workshop that you are going to conduct, and any other observations that you would like to make on the relationship with IIT Bombay, which you are forging using this event. How do you think it will go forward and move forward? So maybe just three or four of you would like to offer some comments. After that, I will request Professor Kannan Maudgalya, whom I have requested to preside over today's function, to say a few words as concluding remarks. And then I will request him to distribute the certificates to all the participants. Okay. So any observations? The house is open for any feedback.
The researcher is concerned. The psychological factor also plays a greater role. If possible, some input may be given in that regard. Especially, any research scholar before presenting his viva, undergoing a viva OC, he would have thought about it nothing less than 1,000 times. That adds so much strain. So if it is told very clearly and means to overcome, that may help. Also regarding little bit ergonomics, when they write thesis, they may not be taking adequate food, though it is a very simple thing, but they will be tired and working a lot. Hence, they may be given some input to take care of their physical health also. If these things are given, a researcher may be able to have a comfort in writing. Thank you, sir.
As just now sir quoted, we were very much enthusiastic to attend this program. That enthusiasm has increased hour by hour, session by session. I hope being teachers, having 10 plus years of experience, sitting from 9 to evening 5 o'clock, it's a very difficult thing. So you made it possible. And every day with one new exciting scope for involving our organizations with IIT Mumbai, and to make use of your guidance, your expertise in our colleges like Scilab workshop and today Akash project and this mega workshop. So we are very much thankful for you, sir, and definitely we'll involve in all your further programs. Definitely we'll be participating for the benefit of our college and also for the nation. Thank you.
I am Dr. Ashish Shah from Delhi. I think this is the start of a new phase, and I must really congratulate Dr. Phatak and his team for this marvelous event and the initiative. 10 years back, I had attended a similar program, which was an impact program, and the program was conducted by World Bank. I am really happy that this time the whole this project is a indigenous means MHRD project, and sir has taken the initiative for the same. To organize an event like this at a very big scale, of course there are some lacunes and some smaller things, but it will be really stupid of us if we see, if we don't see the larger part, and if we just try to find some errors or something. So I just want to say to the whole team that we should see the big picture and move ahead. There are many other smaller things that have been told, like E-Yantra and the Sci-Lab and Nodal Center. So the whole concept is very, it's a very novel cause and novel project. And I wish success, and I'm willing to do whatever from my side and from my institute. Thank you.
Sir, I have been involving with IIT Bombay from the very first workshop what you did, and as well as I have conducted spoken tutorials workshop also. And I find that each and everything what you do is very much useful for all the colleges all over India. And along with this research methodologies workshop, we can have that presentation what we had in effective papers in which one of the professor took how to present the presentations, and that I think the name of that that was excellent, and every participant appreciated that and wanted to have that. So if we have that also as a schedule, that would be very good. It was he was also more interactive and it was jovial. So that's my small suggestion. Thank you very much.
We are all of us are excited, very much excited to be a part of this mega workshop where 10,000 teachers are to be trained. It's a very big event. I would like to suggest a few things. Number one, a topic like how to find a suitable research topic for PhD persuasion. Because many students, they ask that how to go about it. So some tips are given on that. Second is how to write a paper for publication. Some tips on this also, they will be welcome. Thank you.
Good afternoon, sir. I am Dr. Devashish from NIT Agartala. In fact, NIT Agartala is the fastest growing institute right now among the all NITs. And we already had a workshop with you last time with photovoltaics. And we have robotics club and we have software clubs, all these things. So Sci-Lab will be, and the E-Yantra will be very useful for us. In fact, we are looking forward to forge our relationship with you further. Sir, in this in the context of research, I would like to request you one thing, that we have a lot of young researchers, those who are pursuing PhDs and all. For that, if if we can have a workshop on modeling and quantitative technique, especially related to focused with research for researchers, that would be beneficial for the young researchers. That modeling and quantitative techniques, quantitative techniques, that is for young researchers. They are often found confused which how to use models and all. So that will be useful in that way. And this workshop was excellent, and I have personally learned a lot of things still. There's no end to learn, and we are really thankful to your team, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I am Dr. Edwin from St. Xavier's, Nagarkoil, Kanyakumari district. One of my, I'm a little bit concerned is our participants' level of understanding will be definitely little low for the quality of teaching you are providing. So they should not give up in learning. They should understand the level is a little bit higher and they should try to catch up. So one problem they may be facing is the language. So I suggest the participant to keep a dictionary with them so that when difficult words comes, it is better to write and do it. Otherwise, they will give up, especially when we are putting all the videos. Sustaining that listening capacity for 10 days, they should be motivated. 10 days, they should be motivated and they should never give up. Then only they can scale up their level. That is what you are trying, and they should never give up. They should understand they have to move up.
In continuation with that, the afternoon sessions also, if it is too tightly packed, I'm not too sure if people would be able to do. So if you are able to give us, the coordinators, more work where we could interact with them, then I think should be fine, because too tightly packed, as he had already mentioned, wouldn't be taken in the right sense.
Sir, good evening. I am Visagavel from Knowledge Institute of Technology, Salem. Sir, regarding journal paper collections, suppose anybody is doing research, they should know how to collect journal paper from web. Then what are the sites that is science.direct.com, so many sites are there. Another one, AICT now, as a mandatory, all the institution has to go for this journal purchase from, and they have formed one forum. So almost every self-financing institution is going to spend around 15 lakhs. In our institution, almost we have purchased for 15 lakhs. So this year only they have given, so that is permission. Next year onwards, all the engineering colleges have to go for this purchase. So almost 5,000 institutions in all over India, they are going for every institution. Even these total resources will not be utilized by the particular institutions. So suppose if you have any common forum, so through this type of forum, all the engineering colleges, that is those who are joined with the IITB, can access the journal resources. It will be more useful to the researchers, that is budding research scholars.
Well, with this, if we create a private group of the associated faculty members of all the institutes along with the IIT, like just like a forum, then the discussions on that forum can be done regarding the latest topics on which the research can be done. So that if that total group is made along with the in association with the IIT Bombay, then that will be beneficial for the new researchers also. Thank you.
Good evening, one and all present here. First of all, myself, Dr. P.S.K. Patro. I am from Agni College of Technology, Chennai. So I would like to thank the whole team of the workshop coordinators. So it has organized in a very good way. There are two points I would like to mention here. One is, as we are organizing IST workshop on research methodology, there are a lot of things we discussed. But here, some more slides could have added related to what is patent, how one patenting can be done, what are the organizations or agencies are involved. So it would add more values those who have come with the doctorate qualifications. And another thing I would like to inform also, sir, we saw the ACAS tablet, and you are adding many more features and functionalities to the ACAS tablet, like clickers. Like that, we are also working on the Android operating system. If you could extend some support, then we can also contribute few functionalities to the ACAS tablet. Thank you.
The main aim of this workshop is to promote R&D in India, in engineering colleges. But as I find, the workshop addresses only peripheral issues like literacy, sir, how to do literacy survey, presentation skills, and data analysis, etc. But in research, the most important thing is finding problems, finding resource persons as guides, finding other resources like online journal availability. These are not available in many of the private engineering colleges. So how do we address this problem? Unless this problem is suitably addressed, we will not achieve any progress in R&D, whatever we do, conducting workshops, etc. And another thing, you mentioned some themes for this Akash project. Can we have a copy of those themes? I'm CVS Murthy from Kakinada.
I'm Dr. Rajan Varghese from KME Engineering College. See, when I was told that I had to attend 3-day workshop at IIT Mumbai, I had my own reservations and doubts how I can sit from 9 to 5:30 at this age. But thinking the condition of the students to which we are putting them, I thought I'll take it as a challenge. Now, after undergoing this course for the 3 days, I never felt tired or unrest in sitting here. The laboratory classes, they were very encouraging. In fact, I was quite new to this Moodle and Scilab, even though I heard about it. So the laboratory sessions were very useful. Then when I used to think about the research that's going on in our country, I was wondering, if you take 100 colleges as a test dose, so roughly these colleges may be running around 300 programs, research programs. And IISCT gives a strength of 18 to 24, maximum up to 30 students for each stream. So roughly we can say that if you take 100 colleges, around 3,000 students are doing the research. When the country is taken as a whole, think about the large number of students doing the research. So I used to wonder how so many number of projects, topics can be obtained. Definitely the quality will be affected. But after attending this course here, I was convinced that if you do earnest effort, you can get suitable projects, either with interaction with the industry or interaction with the senior professors. I'm sure that if the research scholars are sincere enough, there won't be any difficulty to get good projects. Then one suggestion, because everything is never perfect, one suggestion which came to my mind, which we discussed here also, about the plagiarism. Recently, we conducted a national workshop, and we were happy to see that we got 130 papers. When put for plagiarism, we could hardly select 24 papers. So that shows the volume of plagiarism that is taking place in publishing the papers. Many universities are insisting each scholar has to publish 3 papers, 1 national, like that. So many stipulations. So they were forced to prepare papers. And in the attempt to publish a paper, they go to the easy way of cutting from some other papers. So I suggest have a workshop on this aspect of how to improve the standard of research in our country by cutting away the plagiarisms, similarly by making the course a rigorous course. Many colleges I observed that the PG course is run in a relaxed way. Many classes are not engaged, the students were put to library during the study hours, like that. So I strongly suggest that IIT will take steps to conduct a workshop on improving the quality of research in our country. Lastly, I conclude by thanking the organizations of this workshop on my behalf and on behalf of all my colleagues who are here. My talk will not be incomplete if I don't comment on the stay and the food we enjoyed here for the 3 days. I really congratulate the IIT Bombay, Mumbai, for selecting MTNLL as the guest house. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Respected professors, as far as the success of this workshop, it is one more feather in the crown of your team. Only my suggestion is, one or two sessions can be devoted to the research project funding agencies and the procedure, which can be helpful to the colleges and the faculties.
Good evening, sir. Myself, Kesa Mishra from Sagar Group of Institutions, Bhopal. I would like to all the sessions here as moving sessions. All the sessions were very interesting. one session I would like to submit, some specific sessions would be included. Session devoted for example, communication engineering or for DSP. And one information I would like to submit, our group have tie up with TCS, IBM, and Microsoft, and they are funding us in various modes. So we can accommodate a large number of participants. So one request, one my sincere request, if given an opportunity, definitely we can prove us as a nodal center. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Myself, Atul Srivastav from Bhopal, from Truba College of Science and Technology. I want to say thanks to all team of you in behalf of my college, and myself also. And it is very interactive session. So heartily, I want to say thanks. Two things are very beneficial here. First thing is that in last session, it is discussed that Patak sir has been said that explain it. Students are purchasing projects from somewhere at the undergraduate. So if this type of arrangements are there, this type of study material or things are there available to them, then they will be able to make himself or herself. So it is very good. Second thing is that it is the very good in respect the new researchers that they are getting the opportunity to research, to get the good availability of the resources to make the research itself. And lastly, one thing I want that some researchers are not getting started to make the new research papers. They are feel some problems. And also some new research topics also. A few days ago, I feel that students are feels to make the papers or to do the research in the field of the cloud computing. They don't get the how it can be started. And so I want that, I request that this type of topic should be covered and should be, this type of research work should be represented among them. Thanks a lot.
One last comment.
Respected sir, I am Dr. A.P. Hivrekar from Vidya Pratishthan's College of Engineering, Baramati. I would like to mention one thing, that is if we include some time for LaTeX, because that is very much essential. Most of the journals, they want paper in LaTeX. As well as, one more thing I would like to add, how to write good research project. If we include that, I think that will be beneficial. Thank you.
Thank you. I think we'll conclude now because running out of time. But let me begin by saying that I'm very thankful to you for making a whole lot of observations. First of all, thanks very much for those nice words. We are happy that you are all happy and you enjoyed the workshop. Of course, when you organize anything on a large scale and a larger scale, there are always some lacunae, as our friend said. While we are all willing to gloss over those lacunae, we would like to record them. So my request would be that even a small thing which you found not in order or not in consonance with everything, please don't keep it to your heart. We usually conduct an anonymous survey at the end. I don't know whether Mukta has kept that. It has been done. I hope you have actually contributed, because we would like to correct each and everything. Let me very quickly go through the list of observations. The point made by Professor Sundar Raj on the psychological factor and the stress and physical health is well taken. I think Professor Karmakar does address that issue to some extent. We'll see if it can be expanded. Thesis writing is also an important point. It is actually very similar to writing research papers for which we had conducted a workshop earlier, and all those audiovisual lectures and the course material is actually available. In fact, at that time itself, there was a request on conducting a workshop on how to write journal papers, because that is a slightly different ballgame then writing conference paper. We'll try and keep track of that. We'll definitely request Professor Sonoj to come and give a talk there. Professor Rathod also repeated that how to write a paper and how to select a suitable topic should be perhaps discussed. Partly these will be discussed definitely. For young researchers, Dr. Devashish made a point that something on modeling could be included. You see, there are just too many things, and many of those things are specific to different fields. And therefore, it becomes extremely difficult to consolidate all of them in a common program like this. One of the ideas is that once the nodal centers and additional hubs come up, then it should be possible for one hub to declare a special program for research in electrical engineering, another hub to declare a special program for research in mechanical engineering, and they could all simultaneously conduct it during the same winter vacation window that you have, because different people would be attending those courses. So I will definitely include it in my proposed structure when I make a presentation to the Planning Commission next week. Afternoon sessions are too tightly packed. That was one of the observations. Actually, for some of us, these workshop schedules are very light. Even for the participants, this entire schedule is very light. Maybe it is because of the unfortunate training that we received in early days. My own mentor, Professor J.R. Isaac, used to be there in the department every night, every day, almost 24/7. He used to sleep for 4 hours a day. He expected all of us to do that. At the cost of 2 minutes, I'll tell you a very funny incident that occurred. One day he asked me, one night that is, "Where is Sarda? I have not seen him for the last 2 days." I just kept quiet. 3 days later he said, "Where is Damdere? I have not seen him for the last 5 days." Then I told him, "Have a heart, sir, they just got married recently." And he says, "What has marriage to do with their presence in the department?" Now, I was completely speechless. Then he also thought that he has uttered something wrong. He says, "You know, Fatak, you must tell all our spouses that these people are meant for academic work. Occasionally, they will come home." Now, unfortunately, that is the kind of training that has rubbed onto us. And that is the ethos that we prevail here. Of course, we can't make it too tight for people because participants come from various places. The idea is what someone correctly observed, that if we can make the sessions interesting enough, I think people will participate. But you are very right. We will definitely see to it that out of these 10 afternoons that you will engage with, because there is no vacant day in that tight schedule. So what we'll do is we'll keep at least 3 afternoons where you can freely engage them as per what you think is the most urgent requirement for those people and arrange it in your places. So that point is well taken. The common forum for accessing journal resources, particularly digital resources, is a very good idea. This idea was mooted. I was on a review committee of CSIR, and all CSIR labs, they are trying to say that if we could have a common, a single entity as a group registering for these and paying whatever the charges, then we would be able to get access. Yeah, that is what NKN has talked about. So that probably will happen sooner rather than later. Dr. Patra mentioned that his institute and he himself would be glad to willing on the Android platform. Thank you very much. We will definitely encourage you to do that. And not only you, but when you go back, and in case you decide to participate on the joint project with Akash, we will be requesting you to do a lot of work on Android and subsequently on Linux. So thank you for that observation. Thanks, Dr. Varghese, for your comments that you did not feel tired at all in attending these workshops. Now, plagiarism is a advanced version of the younger people purchasing project reports, you know, plagiarism in paper writing. This is a cancer and this has to be surgically removed. There is no doubt about it, because Actually, the young researchers don't understand, but they are doing a much greater disservice to themselves for their entire future career. Because lies will be caught sometime. Truth always prevails, and there is no point in doing that. Personally, I don't know what the answer is. But we'll try to figure out at least some suggestive measures which we'll include in our these things. Professor Atul Srivastava also mentioned that he referred to the students purchasing projects, etc., etc. I will conclude by saying only one point. Whenever we offer research projects to undergraduate students or to ME MTech students, or later on when the teachers or research scholars select PhD projects, somehow the mindset of both the guides and the students is that something from start to end, completely new and in totality must be done. Then only that project is correct project. Now this is humbug. Incremental research, where you build on something that has already been done, is perfectly all right, provided you have decided on what incremental advancement you would like to make upfront, and you work on that. Now this requires that even the examiners of BTech projects should be welcoming this idea, that there was a lot of work done, this is the incremental addition that people have done, and that is accepted. So this is just one suggestion I would like to make. Thank you very much for all these observations. I would also like to remind you that this is not a workshop on research methodologies per se. This is a workshop on introduction to research methodology. And I take your point very well, sir, that we have discussed a whole lot of peripheral things here, but several major things have not been discussed. We are aware of that. The point is that we did not want to waste any time. Okay, given 6 months, all of us could come up with a much better syllabus, and it could probably cover even 2 workshops, which is perfectly fine. I would only like to mention one thing. The second workshop in this series, which will be conducted next year in the summer, and we will be requesting all the 10,000 participants of this workshop to continue to be engaged with us through the remote center coordinators, and therefore should continue to work towards that particular workshop. The second thing is, we had tried this amongst IITs, NITs some time ago, at least group of IITs, where all research scholars who are doing PhD in different disciplines were brought together, and where they made presentations. And their guides and other guides, I mean all the experts, were available to give comments on. All the research scholars said that that 3 days that they spent, they had the best feedback and criticism on their work. Using the same methodology, in coming years, we would be more than willing, if you agree, then with your support, to conduct such weekend workshops where the researchers, which could be young teachers doing their PhD, could make presentations and receive criticism. Do you agree that this would be useful in future? Fine. So we'll take care of that. You see, there is a lot to be done. We've just begun. And why we believe that we can all do it is because of the strength of this large group here. And as the group becomes larger, the collaborative teams have enormous strength in the world. That is all we are trying to establish. So thank you very much for your participation.
Good evening. As Professor already mentioned, we would like to thank you for taking time out from your vacation to be with us. I have a few comments on some of the feedback. One is that it may have appeared a little tight because the whole thing was condensed in 3 days. Later on, you're going to do this in 10 days. So hopefully, it will not be so tight later. There was a comment about LaTeX workshop, Scilab workshop. It is possible to do them through spoken tutorials because we have already conducted many such workshops. Only thing that is required is for LaTeX, because it's likely that most of you would be using Windows, because it's not clear how many are using Linux. It turns out that if you use Linux, running LaTeX is extremely easy. Installing LaTeX is a lot easier. It's not that you can't do it in Windows, it'll take a little bit of effort. And so what I suggest is, I'm not saying that you should switch over to Linux, which will be a nice thing. But I don't want to give that major task, put that major task as a prerequisite before you can do LaTeX workshop. In case you are interested, you could consider running one LaTeX workshop in your own college with our spoken tutorial team during the next 2 weeks. I can make arrangements so that if you do a workshop, then you will have your systems ready. Then it is possible during the 10,000 teacher workshop, you will have a smooth going. Otherwise, what will happen is if you try to do it during the 10,000 teacher workshop, you may find it difficult to install LaTeX on a Windows system because it requires some effort. That's the only issue. If you are using Linux, there is no it is straightforward. In fact, it turns out that if you switch over to Linux, many of the open source systems will work as a Jiffy. Just go to Synaptic Package Manager, you say install, it'll just get installed. You can't do it in Linux. You can't do it in Windows. It is a lot more difficult. That is the reason, that is the major incentive why you should switch over to Linux. Because all the open source software systems, packages can be installed in those machines at the press of a button. You can't do it in Windows, right? Anyway, that's a different thing. We don't have to get into that. So it is possible to ask my team to help you organize both LaTeX workshop and Scilab workshop even before, so that you feel comfortable, because during the 10,000 teacher training, we want to be very effective. So whoever comes to your center should say that your center had organized it very well. Whatever you are saying here about us, those faculty members who come to your centers should say about you. Okay? So I suggest that you use the 2 weeks, about 10 days time for that purpose. And that the other point that I wanted to make is this methodology of receiving things, delivering courses in one location, receiving in other place, using Moodle, establishing two-way contact, audio-video interaction, all of this are created by the National Mission on Education through ICT. A lot of taxpayers' money has gone into this, and we are fortunate to have been in a position to develop all of this. And I tell you, I recently visited, in fact, during the CFD workshop, in fact, that is happening, I visited 3 centers 2 days ago. I was in Tanjavur, I visited Periyar Maniamma University, I visited Sastra University, I also visited NIT Trichy, and the quality was amazing. And I can't say the same thing about my visit a couple of sessions ago, maybe a couple of years ago. Greatly improved, and so it is just the work that has made this perfect. We are ready to transfer this technology know-how to anybody who is interested, but you have to demonstrate. It should not happen that we spend a lot of effort, just for a waste. So it will be good if you can come up with proposals. You can work amongst yourselves. You can, maybe for your university, between a few colleges, you want to get together and experiment with some of these things. We are ready to transfer the entire know-how to you. Finally, we have a project called ResearchoScope at IIT Bombay. We didn't have time because it was too short a visit, where the recording is available through a website called co-learn. Co-learn stands for corridors of learning, or because we have a long corridor, or it can also stand for collaborative learning, co-learn.in, where our PhD students have given talks on their PhD work in about 45 minutes. So we have recordings of these research scholars, and those are given in an understandable manner. In fact, I said that about 50% of that should be accessible by somebody who has done BTech or MSc in that field, and they have done accordingly. I think that may be one answer to the suggestion here, that we can expand on this. So with that, I would like to thank Professor Fateh for giving me this opportunity, and we can go ahead with the next.
I'll just call the names if you could. It's a long walk, but it would be nice if you could come down. The first name is Mrs. Radhika Joshi, from College of Engineering, Pune. Dr. S. Sudha from NIT Trichy. Oh, that's where you went recently. Mrs. Jayasri Kundargi from Somaya College. Professor Nangopal. Incidentally, some of Mr. Narendra Kumar from BRCM College, Bhiwandi. Dr. Shajin Nargunam. Dr. Vaijayanti. Mr. Rakesh Goyal. Professor Satish Kumar, Mr. Swami Bhukya from Warangal, and then Dr. Prakash Chandra Gupta from Jaipur, Kukas. Kukas has been a partner for a very... Yes. Mr. Ramesh, SRM University, Kanchipuram. Thank you. Dr. V. Madhusudan Reddy. Mr. Om Prakash Dave from Dungarpur. Professor Mahesh Kumar Porwal. Dr. Tejmal Rathod. Professor Nagappan Govindrajan. Dr. Varghese Rajan. Dr. Priscilla Ishan. Dr. Emily Ghosh, Mr. C. Arun Vinod, Emily, thank you. Professor Sunil Mehtre, good to see you here again. Dr. Lakshmi Priya, Dr. Sundar Raj, PhD College, thank you. Mr. Sanjay Sharma, Dr. Prabhat Patel, Professor Vishnu Murthy from Rangareddy. Professor Vishwajit Gayakwad, Dr. Devashish Neogi. I think he has traveled the farthest, so let us give him a big hand. Professor Keshav Mishra, Dr. Visakavel, okay. Mr. Bibin Jose, Dr. Santosh Deshpande, thank you. Mr. Jai Krishna, V. Jai Krishna from Amal Jyoti College. Ms. Neelam Chaudhary from Jaipur. Dr. Murthy V.S. Chebolu. Dr. Arang Swami Kovalan. Dr. R. Edwin Raj. Professor Muhammad Arifuddin Sohel. Thank you. Dr. Kothair Mohideen. Ms. Jomol Joseph Pidikkail, Santosh Kumar Patra, Dr. Smita Chandran, Dr. Anil Hivrekar, Mr. Munir Ahmad Dar, he comes from the northernmost corner of the country, so let's also give him a big hand from DOICC Srinagar. Professor Sandeep Mane, Mr. Arvind Sashindran, Mr. Balram Alam, Mr. Suresh Babu, Dr. Saurabh Channana, Mr. C. Rasik, Mrs. Varsha Zokarkar, Mrs. Darshana Huda, Professor Lalit Vadva, Dr. R. Palani Swami. You had come for thermodynamics program. Yes. Thank you very much. Professor Mahendra Shetty. Mr. V. Arun. Madurai. Dr. Arun Sharma, Ghaziabad is the lone center in Uttar Pradesh. You are the only one from you. Get more people to be enthusiastic. Yes. Professor Dilip Chaugule, Mr. Sanjeev Saini, Professor M. Prabhakaran, Mr. VNS Vijay Kumar, Mr. Virupaksh Khurd, Mr. C. Suresh Kumar, Professor Neeraja Jain, Professor Atul Kumar Srivastav, Dr. K. Sridhar, Dr. B. Jayanand, Professor A. Muralidhar. Thank you. Mr. Ramnivas Gurjar. Mr. Balasaheb Balkhande. Dr. R. K. Jnanamurthy, thank you. Mr. Justin George, Mr. Milind Sakhardande, you have some 4 colleges in Goa. Get all faculty members to attend this workshop. Dr. Ashish Shah, Professor A.K. George, he is one of the future teachers in one of our workshops, that much I can tell you now. Yes. Dr. Kanimoy Servi, thank you. Dr. Bhole, thank you. Mr. Manohar Kohli, Dr. R. K. Selva Kumar, Mr. Mayur Patil, thank you. Mr. G. Vishnumurthy, I think, is already collected this. Professor Krishna Roy. Dr. Gopal Krishna Barkur, he's from Manipal. Thank you. I just remembered that we clap for 2 people coming from extreme east and extreme north. I should not forget the extreme south and extreme west. So let's identify who is from the extreme west. Anybody from Jamnagar, Rajkot? Actually, they were there in the previous workshop. So let us, so let us clap in absentia. Down south, is there anybody from Kanyakumari? 2 people from Kanyakumari. Thank you very much. So the whole nation is represented. Thank you very much. All the best for the main workshop and God bless you.